Keep in touch is when you continue to contact with somebody. Like, for example, I have a friend from kindergarten. We've known each other for 30 years and we still keep in touch. We still contact each other. Doesn't have to be frequently, can be like once a year or so. But as long as we contact each other sometimes, we can say, oh, we keep in touch.
Alright, similar expression.
Stay in touch.
Exactly the same.
Do you stay in touch with your high school friends? Oh, yeah, I stay in touch.
I tend to use keep in touch to talk to my friends back in the States. Hey, Kevin! Hey, let's keep in touch!
You can use it as like a goodbye greeting. It's like, all right, goodbye, see you later. Let's keep in touch whenever you're, moving to different countries or something like that.
Okay. What else do you use when you say goodbye, especially to someone who's far away from you, who you don't see each other that often, but you think, he's a good friend? Do you have any cool expression that you use other than like, let's keep in touch?
Don't be a stranger.
Don't be a stranger.
See you on the flip side.
See you on the flip side.
Drop me a line later.
Drop me a line.
One more thing that a lot of Koreans are confused, which is get a hold of. Can you explain get a hold of?
Get a hold of is when like there's somebody that you need to contact, but it's really hard to contact them because they're never in their office or they don't look at their phone or something like that. Your boss tells you, I need you to contact a guy in the other company, all right? And you said, but boss, I can't get a hold of him. He never looks at his phone and he's never in the office. And then after a couple of days, you're trying and trying and trying, and finally he picks up the goddamn phone and you tell your boss, oh, boss, I got a hold of him.
Good. All right. Any final words to our viewers?
And your final words, don't be a stranger. Let's keep in touch. See you on the flip side. I just used three idioms in one sentence. Nobody would ever do that.
English. Let's keep in touch. Keep in touch라는 건 뭘까요? touch라는 것은 사실 이렇게 하는 것도 touch 이런 표현도 사용하지만 이 touch라는 게 연락이 되다라는 표현이 있거든요. 그렇죠? So keep in touch라고 하면요. 우리 계속 keep 연락을 주고받자라는 표현입니다. 그래서 비슷한 표현 같은 경우는요. stay in touch라는 표현이에요. stay in touch. 보통 저 같은 경우 이제 미국이나 캐나다에 친구들이 좀 있는데 그 친구들한테 제가 마지막으로 이제 전화 통화할 때 마지막 hey, let's keep in touch라고 할수 있고요. 그리고 종종 그렇게 말하거든요. 아니면 제가 이메일을 보낼 때 친구들한테 hey, let's keep in touch라는 표현을 되게 많이 사용합니다. 그래서 이런 keep in touch나 stay in touch라는 거 되게 유용하게 사용할 수 있고요. 그럼 필요가 뭐 설명했던 몇 가지 또 표현이 있어요. 뭐 예를 들어서 draw me a line 이런 거 있죠. draw me a line. 이건 뭐냐면 간단하게 뭐 글이라도 좀 남겨주고 해. 이런 느낌이거든요. Draw me a line. 자, 그 다음에 또 see you on the flip side라는 것도 있는데요. See you on the flip side. 나중에 보자. 이런 느낌이에요. See you later. See you on the flip side. 그쵸? 그런 표현도 뭐 필요는 사용한다고 하네요. 그쵸? 마지막으로 제가 여러분들 보내기 전에 get a hold of라는 것도 매우 유용한 표현이거든요. 여러분들 가끔 가다 보면요. 전화를 했는데 안 받는 친구들 있잖아요. 그쵸? 미치겠죠? 정말 중요한 전화인데 안 받아요. 미칠 것만 같아요. 그쵸? 그때 I was trying to get a hold of you, but you never pick up the phone. Get a hold of. 걔하고 연결하려고 했는데 연락하려고 했는데 걔가 전화가 안될 때, I was trying to get a hold of you, but you never pick up the phone. 이런 식으로 또 사용할 수 있겠죠. Get a hold of. 알겠죠? 자, 그 표현까지 우리 정리해 봤습니다.
I'd rather say goodbye here. Keep in touch, Ryan. I'd rather say goodbye here. Keep in touch, Ryan. I'd rather say goodbye here. Keep in touch, Ryan. I'd rather say goodbye here. Keep in touch, Ryan. I'd rather say goodbye here. Keep in touch, Ryan.
It was nice meeting you.
Let's keep in touch.
It was nice meeting you.
Let's keep in touch.
It was nice meeting you.
Let's keep in touch. Let's keep in touch.
I miss you, man. I want to stay in touch. I miss you, man. I want to stay in touch. I miss you, man. I want to stay in touch. I miss you, man. I want to stay in touch. I miss you, man. I want to stay in touch.
여러분들 저하고 어때요? 어떻게 해야 돼요? Let's keep in touch. Let's stay in touch. 여러분들 어떻게? 아래 답글? 답글? 어? 답글로? 자, 저희하고 keep in touch 해주세요. Drop me a line. See you later. Bye-bye.